Hey everybody, it's Liz, and I'm back to share with you another Christmas project. This time, as you can tell, it's an advent calendar that I created. And I started off with a paper mache advent calendar that you can pick up at Hobby Lobby. And they're quite inexpensive, especially right now. Everything's 50% off, all the Christmas items. So I thought it was a really great deal. And once you add your papers and embellishments, you get a really cute project. So with the paper mache advent calendar, I started off by painting two coats of warm white acrylic paint to all the areas where I knew I was going to cover with papers, you know, the insides of the base, the cubes, all that, and some of the sides, of course, that are not going to get covered up with papers. So I did that, and then I went ahead and I covered all of the areas with the 12 Days of Christmas from Graphic 45, which is one of my favorite collections, and I thought that was such a sweet and perfect collection for the little idea that I had, since it's all about, you know, giving to your loved ones and everything, so I thought it'd be perfect. And so that's the collection that I used, and I'm going to show you real quick the whole thing on all the sides, and then I'll go over in detail as to how I went about decorating my advent calendar. So this is the front, as you can tell. It's got, you know, 25 little cubes. And let me show you the sides real quick. It's a little awkward to show because it is really big, actually. I think it's almost 12 by 12, probably 11 and a half by 11 and a half, but these are the sides. Okay, and this is the back. I really hope I'm in frame so you guys can see the whole thing. Okay, I'm just trying to find the best room with, you know, the best lighting so you guys can see all the details. But I covered everything, front, bottom, back, sides, whatever you want to call it, with the beautiful papers. And I want to show you this little detail that I added to the papers. I'm going to bring this a little closer so you guys can see. But basically what I did, I wanted to go for like a really like a snow flurry look. So what I did to all the edges, I first dabbed some gold acrylic paint on all of my edges. And then I went over that with some Snow Tex. So I really hope you guys are able to see some of that detail. It gives like a little snow flurry effect. It's really cool. See, right here on the top you could probably see it a little bit better, but I wanted to do that all over the advent calendar or the papers, you know, just for a little like a frosty effect. Okay, and I'm going to show you the front real quick so you guys can see all the little compartments. I did that to each of the front of the little cubes as well on all the edges, just to give it, you know, that snowy look. I think it came out really cute. Okay, I didn't do that to the little fussy cut pieces just so you guys could see them better. And don't mind my dog. He's just barking because he hears me talking up here. Can't come up here. But anyways, I just had a really difficult time finding a room with good lighting so that I could do this. So I got to do it in my game room. But anyways, so those are all the little cubes. So you guys can see all the little fussy cut details. Okay. And so let me show you like an example of one of the cubes. How I painted that. So see, they're all painted. Front, back, sides, insides, two coats of warm white. I thought that would be a perfect color to go well with the papers. And then, as you can see, my edges are inked with the, I think I added walnut stain. I wanted to use vintage photo, but I grabbed the wrong one, ended up being walnut stain. But that's fine, because it turned out okay. It's just, you know, to give it a little vintage look. So each of the little cubes is covered with, you know, a sheet of the 12 Days of Christmas paper. Again, I did the gold acrylic paint and the little Snow Tex on top. And then for my numbers, I basically die cut these little labels using the Labels 1 die from Spellbinders. And I coordinated with the green cardstock and the red cardstock. So it's like one is green, one is red, you know, and so forth and so forth. And then for the number, I just used one of my Martha Stewart number stamps that I had. And I used gold embossing powder, and I really like the way that that came out. It makes the numbers really pop. And as you can tell, I did a lot of fussy cutting from the paper collection. I fussy cut a lot of little elements from the 8x8 paper pad because I used that in combination with the 12x12. And I wanted to do like a lot of layers, so you could see some, you know, some of the layers here, how it's dimensional. A lot of these pieces I cut from like different pages, and I sort of put them together, like some of these little leaves and some of the roses, just to add a cute little layered look to each of the cubes. And each of them is different in the fact that they have a different image on them, but of course, you know, they're all the same, they were all done about the same way. Okay, so it's just like, you know, little different fussy cut elements that I added. Like this one's got the little bird. Let's see, really cute, right? And there's a lot of dimension from the foam tape, so it's not so, you know,
one-dimensional there. But those are just some of them. I wanted to show you a couple of the cubes.
Now, the only thing that I did not like about this papier-mâché advent calendar, once you put the two coats of warm white paint, it adds thickness to the sides, and so you have to sand it down pretty good in order for you to put them back in the little compartments. That's my only thing that I didn't really like about it, but other than that, I think it came out, you know, pretty cute. It was a lot of work having to sand all the edges down just to get them in there, and some of them I still can't get in all the way perfectly, but that's okay. But see, this is just another one just to show you some of the little fussy cut details that I added.
Really cute, very sweet. And so each of the cubes is done the same way, just the different elements from the paper pad. Let me show you the Christmas one.
This one's cute, right? It's got fussy cut Christmas word on it, and then I just did that little garland on top, and I thought that was really cute. Very dimensional. It's also, like I said, it's all different little pieces, you know, like the little bows I cut from one paper, the little garland from another, and I just sort of layered them together to give it a cohesive look.
So that is a cube, and I showed you the sides. Now let me show you the back. I did a ton of fussy cutting, again, with this project. I mean, my hands were like kind of numb afterwards from all the cutting that I had to do. But this is the back.
Now, if you guys are familiar with the 12 Days of Christmas, they have this gorgeous signature page. And this is kind of what it looks like. It's got the song lyrics, and it's got a lot of little images all around it. And I really love that page, and I wanted to incorporate it into my project. So what I did is I started off by using one of the music sheets. This is from the same collection. But I adhered that to the back, and then I wanted a sort of frame going around, and so I cut these pieces off a different sheet of paper, and I adhered them on there. Now, I did have to cut them down to size because it's not a 12 by 12 area, so I did cut them down to size, and it fit perfectly, you know, sort of like a frame. And then these little squares, you know, were cut differently, or separately, I should say, and I added them, and there's a cute little pearl in the center of these little flowers, but I'll show you once I bring it closely. And so this, then I fussy cut that out, the song lyrics, and then a bunch of these little images as well from the paper collection. And I just wanted to give it almost like a collage look, similar to the signature page of this collection, because I really like it. And again, a lot of fussy cutting, a lot of foam tape to give them dimension. And let me just bring it a little closer so you can see some of the cute details. Okay, as you can see there. Very cute, and a lot of the elements are layered one on top of the other, just to, you know, give it that look. And those little frilly or lacy pieces that you see kind of poking out are actually parts of an older paper that I had from Anna Griffin. It's like a little doily paper, and I just kind of liked the detail, so I wanted to tuck that behind the song lyrics. So I hope you guys are able to see that. It's just a cute little detail, that's all. And but that just kind of shows you. So some of the fussy cut elements are tucked underneath, on top, over the pages, over one another. So, you know, lots of layering going on. I think it came out really cute. All right, now let me show you on top what I did. Like I said, the 12 Days of Christmas is all about giving. And so I wanted to create like a really cute sort of Christmas day or Christmas morning scene on top. You know, with the Christmas tree and all the little presents and stuff. So I thought it came out really cute. And, let me see, I think I could probably just get a little closer so you guys can see. Okay, alright, sorry about that. Okay, but let me start for what I did here. I started off with, actually just bring it close to you, might work out better, huh? Alright, I started off with the Christmas tree. The Christmas tree is from the Dollar Tree, and it's almost like a little foam tree. It already had a little bit of white on it, but I wanted a really snowy effect, so I dabbed a lot of gesso on it to give it that snowy look, and I think it came out really nice. And then I wrapped this little beaded trim that I picked up at Hobby Lobby. It's gold. I wrapped it all around the tree to sort of to mimic garland, and then I also used a little bit of gesso to tone down some of the gold. And then I really like these cute little ribbons I saw at Hobby Lobby. They're so cute. They're little plastic ribbons that you can find in the, the ornament section for like a little mini Christmas tree. This is what they look like. It's a pack of 12 and they're plastic. Super cute. And in the center they've got like a little wire, but I took the wire off and so it leaves like a little bit of an opening. And I basically just added a little red rhinestone to the middle to cover that little hole. That's all I did. And then I adhered them onto my little Christmas tree with some hot glue. And you can see the little ribbons, or little bows, I should say, all over the Christmas tree. It came out really cute. And then I picked up a pick from the Dollar Tree. You can see the little drum there. I just took it apart because I really like the drum with the red and the gold. I adhered it on there, and I added this cute little wedding dove I picked up at Joann's. It's nice and glittery, and I just added it on there. And then all the little gift boxes you see, I made by hand using scraps from the 12 Days of Christmas collection. So I made a bunch of cute little gift boxes and little gift bags. They're so cute. They are very easy to make too, and just darling. I think they look so cute in the little tree. Some of them I decorated with ribbon. Some of them I added like a little tiny flower, like that middle one right there. And some I added like little strips from the paper collection, just to give it, you know, a little detail. And then over here I made a couple more, and then you can see the little gift bags in the back. Look how cute they are. Those are so easy and so cute. And I just added like little tissue inside. The handle is made out of some twine that I had in my stash. And then I wanted this cute little wagon on there. Look how cute. This is from the miniature section at Michael's. And I thought it would be perfect for my little Christmas morning scene. So I've got a little wagon. I've got another little gift inside, and then the cute little teddy bear. And the teddy bear I also picked up at the miniature section, but this one was from Hobby Lobby. And I think he's so cute, right? So he's just sitting in the little wagon, and it's just like a really pretty, festive Christmas morning scene. I think it came out really cute. And let me see here. I think I covered everything. Oh, I forgot about the star on my tree. The star on my tree is one of those Tim Holtz stars. And you know how, I think they're acrylic or mirrored or something like, I think they're called mirror stars. And I just used multimedium. I dabbed it on there and then I added the gold glitter. And it's on both sides too, or all over the star, I should say. Because I wanted to go for, you know, a red and gold Christmas tree. And I thought that'd be perfect. And I just like the idea of the way that the star is dimensional, so. I think that came out cute. I love the way my tree came out. I love it. I think it's so cute. I really hope you guys like it as well. And Kayla loves it. She saw it yesterday. I actually finished this a few days ago, but excuse me, I haven't been able to make a video because the weather's been horrible here, so my lighting is just, it's terrible. This is probably the most decent day so far. But anyways, that is my advent calendar, you guys. I am so happy with the way that it turned out, and of course, I'm very thrilled that it's, Christmas, and I've got a lot more Christmas projects to do, so I will be sharing more projects in the future, or in, you know, in the near couple of days or whatever. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you guys all had a wonderful Thanksgiving. I really appreciate all your sweet comments and questions and stuff. It's really sweet, everyone that keeps watching and supporting me, so I really appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much, and I will be seeing y'all real soon. Bye!